So hello everyone, my name is Johan Rockström. I'm a professor in global sustainability science at Stockholm University and heading the Stockholm Resilience Center. Humanity has reached a new juncture. We are 7.6 billion co-citizens on Earth, committed to 9 billion just in the next 30 years. We have a world economy projected to grow three times just over the next one and a half generation. And we're also set to take ethical responsibility for human well-being for all co-citizens on Earth. The drama is, and what really changes the entire agenda on sustainable development, is that we now have empirical scientific evidence from across all disciplines that we have, just over the last 50 years, gone from being a relatively small world on a big planet, where we actually could deliver development by encroaching, exploiting, emitting more greenhouse gases and polluting more. Basically, we could succeed with partial or even full unsustainable development. But until very recently, when this still worked, we've now reached a point where we no longer can deliver human well-being on those premises. We are now the relatively big world on a small planet. We've filled up the entire planetary space. In fact, to the extent that we're now hitting the ceiling of hardwired biophysical processes that regulates the stability of the entire Earth system. Can you imagine? Development, human development, can actually threaten the stability of the entire planet. So where does this evidence originate from? Well, it is from something that is now scientifically very well established, what we now call the Great Acceleration. We come up until the early 1950s, where we have, 8,000 years of civilizational evolution since the last ice age, essentially. We have linear and incremental impacts on the Earth system. Yes, we do expand agriculture, we do expand empires, we do start exploiting rare earth metals, but we have largely no indent on the Earth system as a whole. Mid-1950s, we embark on what is called the Great Acceleration. We go for exponential rise in pressures on essentially all the parameters that matter for human well-being and development. Exponential rise in pressures from loss of biodiversity, eutrophication, air pollution, deforestation, land degradation, so on and so forth. This is so large, in fact, this pressure, that science has now come to the conclusion that we've entered a whole new geological epoch. Can you imagine? We're leaving the Holocene, the stable interglacial state we've been in since the last ice age, when we have developed as a modern civilization on Earth. And we're now entering the Anthropocene. Anthros for us humans. We, humanity, are the dominating force of change on planet Earth. We exceed the natural drivers of change like earthquakes and volcanic eruptions and even our distance to the sun. We hold the future of our planet in our hands. Now you may think that that is like the most dramatic message, but it is not. Because you see, during this acceleration, the resilience of our planet has been extraordinary. In fact, we go into this exponential rise of pressures in the 1960s, 70s, 80s, and we have so much biodiversity, we have so fantastic ability of the oceans and forests to absorb and buffer our pressures, that in fact we continue to deliver development with little invoices from the Earth system. It isn't until the late 1980s, early 1990s, that we get so much scientific evidence that we have reached a saturation point, where we start seeing tipping points being crossed and sudden, abrupt, and irreversible changes that start hurting our development. You see for the first time the collapse of the cod fisheries out of Newfoundland in the late 1980s. You see sudden collapse of lake systems from systems that can really deliver human well-being and ecosystem services to dead, murky, oxygen-free dead zones. You see the accelerated rise in melting of ice in the Arctic. You start seeing the collapse of coral reef systems across the world. So from the 1990s onwards, we've not only entered a whole new geological epoch, where we're the driving force number one, we've also reached a saturation point. So this is why sustainable development now has to be redefined. The entire biosphere is shaped by humanity. We are affecting all the components of the Earth system. We're the big driver of change. And moreover, if we continue in an unsustainable path, we can no longer exclude very, very large, costly social and economic invoices hitting back from the Earth system. So dear friends, welcome to the Anthropocene. This is what really defines sustainable development. You've certainly followed the journey of sustainable development throughout the decades with the Brundtland Commission, the Rio Conference in 1992, the modern definition of sustainable development, where we define it as, the capacity of this generation to generate human well-being without undermining the ability of future generations to be able to generate their development and human well-being. Well, scientifically, of course, this is something that still holds, but it only works on a stable planet. Today, we need to rethink sustainable development to say that sustainable development in the world today is when we can generate human well-being within the safe operating space of a stable and resilient Earth system. We need to reconnect to the biosphere, we need to become planetary stewards, and we need to recognize the pace and scale and connectivity of all development. It's no longer sufficient to develop water supply for small-scale farmers and communities in water-scarce regions in the world without recognizing that that investment may be undermined by unsustainable consumption patterns in large parts of the rich world, which may have ample water resources. So we're all connected, and we have to address development universally across the entire planet. The Anthropocene also has, as you may start then just seeing from this first setting, very dramatic equity dimensions. Because if it is so that we've filled up the entire space on Earth, if we're starting to hit the ceiling, which means that we have to stay within a safe operating space on Earth, then of course it means that we have to share the remaining natural resources, atmosphere, biodiversity, all the components of the Earth system that gives us stability and human well-being. We also have a challenge of that generating an equitable human well-being for humanity. So this is the new phase of development in the Anthropocene, a phase which we've never seen before, a phase that requires completely new thinking in how we can generate sustainable development for all co-citizens as a big world on a small planet. Is there any hope and light in the tunnel? Well, I would argue yes. In 2015, the world signed in the General Assembly, all nations in the world, the Sustainable Development Goals. This is the first time ever we have a universal plan for a desirable future for people and planet. This might sound obvious for us who work in sustainable development, but we've never had that before. We now have a quantitative roadmap that integrates very, very aspirational and important equitable goals to eradicate all poverty, all hunger, good human well-being, good quality of life for all citizens in the world within a stable and resilient Earth system. We have goals for climate, for biodiversity, for oceans, and for fresh water. This is a roadmap which changes the entire agenda for sustainable development and takes us to the conclusion, which is now, as a big world on a small planet, when we are deep in the Anthropocene, where we can no longer exclude tipping points that can give us invoices back that would undermine development, we have light in the tunnel to transform human well-being to a 100% fully sustainable future within a safe operating space where we reconnect to the biosphere, where we become planetary stewards and do planetary stewardship in combination with action on the ground with local communities for the prosperity of everyone on Earth. So I really look forward to engaging throughout this whole MOOC, which is an effort of really being at the cutting edge of sustainable development in the Anthropocene. Thank you.